Well then, JT couldn't make it tonight. So now it's sent to play one of his favorite genres without him. Oh, JT get dunked on, man.
Listen, if it makes anyone feel any better, I told Marek, listen, we shouldn't play this without JT, knowing how much he loves this game and everything like that. And then Marek was like, shut up, or else I'll lose your moderator status and shit. And then I'll kick you off of the stream and whatnot, because I'm Marek1shtar. I'm top dog around here.
Bullshit. Lies and slander, sir.
I'll see you in court, Marek.
Where? Pennsylvania court?
Yeah, Pennsylvania court. It's trial by the pizza that ate Denver and whatnot, as you like
to call it. Fucking, what's his
Judge
face?
Gritty Design. Resigning. I can't fucking speak for shit tonight.
This is kangaroo court.
Yeah, this is kangaroo court. Now, let's get this fucking show on the road now.
It'll be a storm now. This is kangaroo court. What a load. Shoot outside of the screen. You know what's funny? We've not beaten this on stream at all. Like, not once. But you know what's funny is ever, like, off stream, I've beaten this game 3 times.
Yeah.
All right, so let me, friends only, blah, blah, blah. Let me invite you in.
I'm already in.
Oh, cool. All right, let's do this, son bitch.
All right, so I don't really have that many motherfuckers and everything on this, but I'm just gonna go as the robot multi. All
right, so then I guess I'll play as he, because usually when JT's around, I'll play like one of the weirder classes, but I'll stick to what I know for the stream, which is this guy. Let me.
Again, you have more fucking characters than I do and whatnot, but then again, yeah. I don't really play this game all that much.
It's not even that. I actually can get you a character if we just, like, try to do, like, one random thing. You'll see when we beat a stage and there's gonna be like a blue portal. If we go in there, how many of those blue coins do you have underneath your regular set? Four.
Yeah.
I forgot. I think it's like 5. So if I remember correctly, I don't remember exactly how many that was, because I don't think I bought it. I don't think I got the other character on stream or anything like that. So. That's the biggest question there. Whoa. But yeah, like we could probably net you a character.
Yeah.
We could probably net easily net you a character if you get like 5 coins, if I remember correctly. It's either 5 or 15. I forgot. I think it's five.
It's divisible 5, I guess.
Yeah, I think it's 5 because they don't really charge you a lot in the coins department. Like, there's certain chests where all you gotta spend is like 1, and then you get like an item or whatever.
Right.
And I've done that on a few occasions there, and I so wholeheartedly regret it.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see what we got here. Take the armor. But you know, I'm gonna try to play through this again as the commando, because this is like the only character that I've beaten this on, by the way.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, because the freaking the railgunner's broken as shit. Cable's jacked and he's got a robo arm. Hey Zig, you need move. Zig, I found a thing. I found a thing. You want movement speed?
Oh yeah, sure. My guy's pretty fucking slow.
Yeah, there's a can up here.
All
Let
right.
me. There we go. I pinged it.
All right, I'm coming. I'm coming.
Man, look at how much fun we're having in chain. Oh my god, imagine if we were fucking like that.
You know, I was gonna say, you better be careful, Marek, or else next, and then I'm like, oh, wait a minute, no. You're the DM now, you're the captain now and shit.
I'm the captain of the ship. I treat all of my players fair and, you know, I treat all my players fair and cut from the same cloth. But if you fuck with me like a bunch of fucking bees, I'll sting you all at once and kill you.
Yeah.
All right, everybody, now sing the Marek is Great song if you want to live.
Marek.
Oh my god.
He is so cool.
I know the song you're saying.
Patrick, Squidward's Andy, Mr. Krabs, Plankton Gary.
Oh my god, it just devolves into that. It's so real.
Yeah.
It's the perfect
Marek1shtar
anthem.
Yeah.
Oh my fucking god.
Marek1shtar.
Where'd you put the bottles of soda? Bottles of soda, same thing, put them in the freezer. Oh, fuel cell. Activate the fuel cell. Did you find the TP yet? Oh.
Nah, I haven't found the TP yet.
We got some time, so we really. Yeah. We're not gonna fucking die.
Nah, we're gonna live forever and shit.
I forgot what character JT plays. He plays as like the weird plant thing, and then he ends up like blowing up or whatever.
Well, I think I found it.
What's up?
I found the teleporter.
Oh, cool. I don't think there's much else to explore. So, oh wait.
Oh.
Wait, I got it. Just in the nick of time, too. What is it? Oh, fuck you, jellyfish. Perfect timing on the jellyfish. Jellyfish. Take the coin if you want it.
I got the lunar coin.
Yeah, so that you at least get like 5, so you get the character.
Yeah.
All right. So basically, I don't know how to make the portal appear. I know JT. No, like there's a specific thing you have to do, I think. But I just kind of have it like randomly appear, and I just go into it sometimes.
All right.
Eventually we'll do the thing. So.
Yeah.
More often than not, we're gonna see the portal. Oh, hey, there's something over it. Wait a minute, what is that? Is that... Oh, it's a chest. So once this ring goes away, we should have access to it, not... Mr. Krabs. Mr. Krabs. Oh, God. Alright. Chest ho! What do we got? Ooh! Got a spear!
Nice.
Oh, hey, more items!
Oh, cool.
Let's see what we got up here. We got a key, we got a booster shot. Do you want a booster shot or do you want the chest? That answers the question.
The chest.
Oh. Oh, well, it's just a rose buckler.
Oh, okay.
It's only good when I'm sprinting. Alright, cool.
Alright. Let's head to the teleporter.
TP on me!
Alright.
Actually, there is a good build for this, because there's items that you can use, you run around and you just zap stuff on its own and you attack on your own.
Yeah.
So in theory, you can live forever. And just do nothing but run around and take less damage. Alright.
Alrighty then.
Aw, crap, we don't got any cash.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's see what we got. I really hope we don't encounter the mice. I hate... And as soon as I say that, they appear. Knowing our luck, we're probably gonna get, like, those void enemies that just kill us on impact or whatever.
Yeah.
It's like antimatter touches regular matter, and then we all die.
Mm-hmm.
Hold on. Usually, there is a consistently gotten something to spawn up here.
Oh, okay.
Hey, look at that. Another thing of a bob.
Yeah.
Let's see what we got in there. What is this? Regenerating scrap paranoids use. Ah.
Oh. Oh, wait, no,
wait, what happened? You fell?
Yeah, like, I know you get fall damage and shit, but you don't fucking,
you don't die. Whoa, these guys are... What's this?
Huh.
I got like a weird piece of... Oh, monster log.
Oh, cool.
Lore! It does nothing. Ooh, detonate enemies on kill. Actually, this is pretty good with the guy here.
Yeah.
Let's see. About yum 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 in a liverwurst a la mode.
Hey, it worked!
Oh god, I wish there was like detect hidden skills in this type of game, but nah.
Yeah, that'd be fucking cool.
Nah, bro, like, I still say one of the best implementations of a thing like that is still in Kingdoms of Amalur. Because of the giant rock wall. And then all of a sudden it's just like, it opens up and boom, you're in like a whole new section of the map that you didn't have before. Hey, movement speed in this hoof. Also, the coffee gives you movement speed too.
Oh, cool.
And damage boost. Alright, where are our enemies? I want to shoot stuff.
I see some enemies right there.
Ooh, alien head reduces cooldown of your skills. So now I can shoot this more often. my Ghostbusters gun. That weirdly has the
ghost.
Put the ghost in the crack pipe and smoke. My soul pipe. Oh, got him. I'm under attack. Hey, I found the teleporter. Hold on. We can go around and collect more stuff since we know where it is. Put the ghost in the crack pipe and smoke.
Jeez.
Somehow, I don't know how I unlocked the loader. I think you bought... He is melee and you just kind of like... You get a grappling hook though and he... I tried playing him for 5 seconds and I said I have to play this with somebody else because I don't trust myself with a melee character in a game like this.
Oh, alright.
Oh, did we forget a chest? I think we forgot a chest.
Oh, yeah. Oh,
oh no.
Oh, hey.
It's all good. Yeah, you don't die instantly when you fall in the pit.
Cool. Because my jumping is, stilted and shit.
You don't jump bad. You don't jump good.
Nah, I don't jump good at all.
Stupid jumping.
Stupid sexy jumping.
Jump bad. No.
Wait, what's over?
No, these potatoes are bad. Oh yeah, an equipment drone.
Potatoes are great.
No, the potatoes are bad. These potatoes are the best potatoes. No, they're bad.
These potatoes are amazing.
These potatoes are the best potatoes. I want my slaw.
You have your slaw, sir.
Is your name Chewy Rodriguez?
My name is Han. Chewy Rodriguez.
I lived. I left.
I left.
I loved. The zipper's just stuck. Do you think? No. Here's the real question. Do you think that the freaking microwave made the zipper stuck?
Yeah, I can see that happening.
It melted to his skin, Zig.
Oh my god, that reminds me of the fucking Aqua Teen episode where, you know, Meatwad has like the cursed t-shirt and shit.
The cursed t-shirt?
The t-shirt where you can like grant wishes and whatnot. I'm the Easter Bunny!
Oh yeah, why did you wake me up? Why did you wake me up from my...
It's the middle of July!
Why did you wake me from my slumber, Meatwad?
What? Oh, look, it's a giant Easter egg!
And they had to fix him with a football. God.
Oh, this suit has melted into my skin.
No! Hey, Zuki, don't you agree that all national anthems are country music? Shut up! Shut up! That's wrong! God damn it, Zuki. Oh, I got a goat hoof!
Yeah, I also have a goat hoof. Goat hoof.
How does it appear on you? How does it appear on you? Because it replaces my leg. I get like a freaking salami leg.
I still have my wheels and shit. So, you know, the wheels on the bus go round and round.
Oh, God. Imagine it, like, it replaces the wheel with, like, a mangled, fucked up goat leg that's, like, half, that's, like, half formed into, like, a fucking circle or something. Stupid little bitch, better fuck up. Is that a pot head? What?
Yeah.
Did I win? What just happened?
I ask myself that question every day.
What the fuck just happened here?
I don't know.
Stupid little bitch, better shut the fuck up. Is that a void chest? Hey, Zig!
Oh, nice.
Oh, wait, it's a... Oh, wait, don't go to it. It's a coin chest.
Oh.
I always tend to buy the ones that they have to give up 50% of your health for the little bit.
Oh, yeah.
Because that one's, like, actually... decent.
Yeah.
Alright, what was I doing? I'm gonna head back to the thing, but yeah, no, like, how you said, like, I was thinking of what when you were going, the wheels on the bus go round and round. That reminded me of this old fucking YouTube video I watched. It was called, like, Cannibal Town?
Uh-huh.
Yeah. And, like, it had a sequel, Cannibal Town 2. And there's a scene in the sequel where they're on, like, there's a scene in the sequel where they're on, like, a bus. Oh, Gubu mm-hmm. Jr. makes a clone of you. Gubo Jr. So yeah, like they're escaping from the zombie. It's basically a town full of zombies, right?
Yeah.
And they're they're escaping on the school bus. They're like, the wheels on the bus go round and round. It's so fucking bad.
I was also thinking too, like that fucking Family Guy skit where, you know, fucking Brian's on shrooms and whatnot, and Peter's getting fucking like spit roasted and shit.
I
just thinking the wheels on the bus go round and round.
I reject your reality and substitute my own. We like being alive. We like being alive. Oh, we like being a we like being a we like being alive. I reject that reality and substitute my own.
Ah, alrighty then.
Do you like my soothing voice? Return the map. Return what you have stolen from me. Never in a million years would have thought a Family Guy would have made that fucking reference.
So you want to activate this teleporter or what?
Yeah, hold on, wait, we got an adaptive chest.
Oh, okay, cool.
We like being alive.
Oh, we like being alive. Oh, we like being, oh, we like being, oh, we like being alive.
You know something?
Yeah.
I sit over here. Standing here, I realize. You know how Norm MacDonald played Death?
Yeah.
You know what the worst part about that is that we're probably never getting him back. Wait a minute, what does this do? You and all your allies enter a frenzy. The fuck is that? What the hell does that mean? Also, where are all these Octotards coming from?
Oh, you know, here, there, everywhere.
Hold on, where's... Let me just kill one enemy. I want to see if I can get this shrine a chance here. Because I found a equipment drone over there that I could apply this to. If I really wanted to like have it be like a secondary passive.
Yeah.
Oh hey, bomb.
You want it?
Alright, let's do this shit. Let's do it! Alright, I gotta wait for my gun to cool down. You know the oh god. You know the funny thing about, like, just fighting, like, these pothead dudes?
Yeah.
In fucking, whatchamacallit, the game that I'm playing, Death's Whatever.
Oh, Death Store?
Yeah. They have a, whatchamacallit.
Yeah.
Oh god. There's a character that helps you out named Pothead. I'm even like, what's his name? Pothead? This big, you know, I'm thinking back to fucking Okami, and then I'm like, god damn it.
I am Blockhead!
Pothead. What do you mean it's not a weed reference? He offers you soup from his head. He's like, soup?
Oh, that's cool.
Don't trust me not by the Tupperware of my head, but by the contents of it. Want some soup? And your character just casually refuses, and I'm just like, come on, man, drink the soup. They ain't gonna kill you.
Yeah.
I really want to stream Death Store one of these.
Yeah, one of these days you should stream it, dude.
Probably Saturday.
Probably.
Standing here, I realize. But yeah, it. My question is, why the fuck did they stop? Like, why the fuck did they stop having Norm Macdonald on Family Guy as Death, and before he passed away? You know what I mean?
Maybe some, like, you know, scheduling issues. I'm not really sure, to be quite honest with you.
Like, he didn't have to, you know, he didn't have to be on all the time as Death. Like, you know, he doesn't, you know what I mean?
Yeah, that is true.
It's like, there was a lack of the really good recurring characters, like, in the later seasons of Family Guy, where I'm just like...
Mm-hmm.
They have, like, small plot lines go away.
Yeah.
In favor of, like, nothing burgers. Oh, hello.
Basically shit that doesn't go on, that goes on for, like... It just leads up to nothing and shit, and it's just like... This is the best that motherfuckers can do?
It's the Slender Man!
I'm not saying that last part. You can't make me.
Air tax too high, can't afford to breathe. Imagine getting taxed by the air you breathe.
Oh, look, it's adoration so heavy.
Oh god, and I just remembered that that's a thing in the- Oh. I try to forget. And you know what the sad thing is? I actually think the Lorax is okay.
I know.
Ooh, we got more. Got a voodoo doll. And what is this? Some kind of voodoo doll? All right, Zig.
What's up, man?
You get a voodoo doll of the goo. You get some voodoo dolls of the Goo Goo Dolls. How do you feel?
Well, time to end some careers.
Where are they now?
Probably torn.
The Goo Goo Dolls. My question is, why the fuck would you name your band the Goo Goo Dolls?
Why the hell not? You know, there are other fucking worse names out there. You can name your fucking band Cock and Ball Torture.
Hello,
that's an actual fucking name of a band, by the way.
Like, and it's not even like a pun of it. It's just played straight. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And I think that's the worst part about it. Oh yeah, we're gonna let's name our band.
You know what? I'm gonna name, if I ever make a band, I'm gonna name off my band Google Keys.
We all CBT.
No, I said Boo Boo Keys.
Boo Boo Keys. You know what? I'd actually listen. What's your style gonna be?
I would think. '90s punk alternative.
'90s punk
like
alternative.
Something like The Offspring. Something like The Offspring. Something like that, you know what I mean?
Would you do rap rock?
That'd be my side project.
Honestly, I want to use the stage. I want to use Aloysius O'Hare as a stage name for something. Everybody enjoy the comedy stylings of Aloysius O'Hare.
Hey, Merrick, do you want this moon coin I found?
Sure, I can take it. Sure, I'll take it. Okay. You don't want it?
Nah, I'm good. I picked up a few along the way. Might as well give you some, you know what I'm saying?
Alright, I just gotta find my way back up. Where did all this money come from?
From the money fairy.
And then I notice I'm carrying two fucking pennies. Hey. I'll count the money, and I'll count the money. It's me, the puberty fairy. I'm here with Luigi to tell you a whole heap of pasta pile of information.
Hello, Mario.
This is what we've been reduced to? This?
I mean, yeah. I mean, have you watched our fucking streams, Merrick?
I'm not talking about the streams. Also, I watch one every day to reminisce on the to reminisce. Is that even been that long?
I know. I was actually watching because I know fucking, you know, Mr. Funny Haha Funny Man, Toby Fox made like an April Fool's joke about chapters 3 and 4 and whatnot.
Mm-hmm.
I was watching the Delta Room streams and shit, because honestly that's like one of my favorite fucking streams that we ever did for an RPG Tuesday.
And? I don't know, you made it like you have like a big revelation about something. At least it's
that time when JT's girlfriend came into chat.
Oh yeah, we got fucking stun locked for like a little bit just to.
Yeah.
Standing. He had a moment of why are we still here just to suffer.
Mm-hmm.
Standing here, I realize.
Because we just kept fucking, you know. We just kept, you know, ragging on the motherfucker for who knows how long.
Everybody point and laugh at JT's humiliation.
Yeah. You want Goobo Jr.?
No, I don't have Goobo Jr. What did you get?
No, I'm asking, do you want Goobo Jr.? Because I already have Goobo Jr. and shit.
Cause I don't know what the Gorag's Opus does. It says like, oh, it puts you in a frenzy, but it's like, but what does that mean? Really?
I think maybe a frenzy and like, you know, when we do like the teleporter, shit and whatnot, you know what I mean?
It does make sense, actually. Cause I used it there and it didn't seem like it did. I think I'll take Goobo just to have like an extra thing.
Oh.
Yeah, Goobo. Goobo's actually.
I already took him. Sorry.
Oh, I thought you had another one.
Yeah.
You can't have two. You can only have one.
What?
Yeah. He's a triangle use item. Yeah.
Oh, right.
Gorag's Opus. Man, I can't get the freaking missile launcher. I get stuff that cleanses quote unquote status ailments and shit.
Here, take.
I get stuff that cleanses and stuff that barely works. But when I play solo, I get like all the freaking, you know. I get the BFG. I get the freaking You know what? I think that the whatchamacallit's actually pretty good.
Yeah.
What's the name of that? The black hole. I couldn't think of the. Cause it doesn't kill stuff. It's not like, you know, when you get like one of those black hole guns in like Saints Row or for, like those open, you know, like an open world games black hole gun, which just sucks stuff in because, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah, we all know what you're here for. Oh! Void chest!
Oh, cool.
Let's see what I get. Encrusted key. Oh! This corrupts all of your keys if you get them. And basically all of, like, all the lockboxes become, like, void chest stuff.
Hmm.
Standing here, I realize the song is actually pretty good with a but it has a not so great opening. Oh fuck.
That's alright. I'll take that.
Take the coffee, yeah.
Oh yeah. For the coffee corner tonight.
I'm a menace? What do you want? Also, sorry if I'm slow to responses. I'm trying to react to all the stuff on screen. Oh, because we're dunking on JT while just playing this without him. I tend to forget that,
Hoodie is, like, JT's number one fan.
Yeah.
And JT's only fan.
JT's only fan. Everybody else comes in here and they're like, everybody, let's point and laugh at JT's humiliation. Oh my god. Like, you know what the funny part is? He still hasn't watched that stream where we did the coffee corner without him. JT funny. He is funny.
He is.
Even what he's done.
He busts his chops a lot and shit like that, but you know. He is a funny guy and whatnot. He's a funny little dude.
You know what be the ultimate torture of a clown?
What?
A clown that everything he says, even when he's being serious, is treated as if it's funny.
I actually saw that earlier today.
Like, think about this for a second. Imagine you're going, like, you get, like, a grievous injury. You're, like, bleeding out or whatever, right? And then you're trying to get help, and everybody's just laughing at you.
Yeah. No, I legit actually saw that earlier today and shit. Like, somebody, like, an artist friend of mine was actually, like, having a fucking, like a little bout of like imposter syndrome and shit, you know what I'm saying?
Imposter syndrome?
You know, because, you know, he's like, do I really deserve all this, like, you know, all the fucking fame and recognition I get and whatnot, you know what I'm saying?
That's the worst part about being a creator, when you're always down on yourself and then
And everybody was just like, oh, Among Us? You know what I'm saying?
It's so kind of like, you know, it's kind of like that one scenario where, like, you ever see the video of the guy who has, like, the seizure in full body VR on VR chat, right?
Yeah.
And like, one of the people who's doing, like, the Uganda Knuckles thing, like, goes up to him and is doing it as he's on the ground and shit. It's like, imagine you have, like, a condition like that and you just log on to VR chat and the last thing you hear before you die is, do you know the way? And shit like that.
Oh my god.
Like, think about that for a second. Just think about that for a second.
Yeah.
You know?
Wasn't one of the, like, fucking bystanders, like, an actual, like, fucking, like, an EMT or a nurse or some shit?
Something like that. It's, like... But, yeah, like, stuff like shit... But, you know, like, the whole imposter shit... WHAT THE FUCK IS THAT?!
That's the Grove Tender.
Well, we killed him. That was easy. But yeah, no, like imposter syndrome, like I feel like it even happens when you. I feel like it even happens even before anything is made or posted. Like, Zig, I can't believe I spent, like, a while writing, like, bits for a comic strip. And I wrote about, like, that's a boss, Merrick. JT knows what a boss is. Oh, come on, Hoodie, you don't just come here for JT.
Yeah. You come for the arguably the best part of the fucking stream. And that is me, Gur Ziggler.
Well, you know something, Zig, like, I compare you to Hannibal Buress. So, yeah, I feel like a lot of people watch Eric Andre just for the Hannibal Buress bits. But the thing is, you know, the truth is about that, Zig, is that they actually do kind of bounce off each other, so it does help when one person is funny, because that means the other person is also funny. Oh.
Whatever helps you sleep at night, Merrick. I'm joking.
If one person is funny, that means two people are funny.
Oh.
Well, he's dead. I didn't need to use my freaking laser.
Nah.
Standing here, I realize. Oh no, that song's fucking stuck in my head, ain't it?
Yeah.
I know, but I only hear JT once a week, and I mainly come here for the dynamic duo funny commentary and Merrick trying his hardest to be good at video games. it's either we stream or we don't stream when JT's not around, and honestly, I like streaming, so I try to do something. I fuck with JT like this because it's honestly kind of funny when it's just like, haha, we're playing one of his favorite video games. Wait.
I play video games.
Where am I getting shot at from?
Probably up top.
I got us a drone.
Whoa.
Why is it getting all dark? What the fuck was that? It got all dark and... Hello. FX! Good to see you, buddy.
Hey, FX.
Oh god. Am I near the bathroom?
Are you the TV repairman?
Oh, yeah, Zig, wait a minute. Did you get the, did you ever use the shurikens?
No, I haven't used the shurikens.
They're just extra regular attacks. They're great.
Oh, cool.
Yes. Standing here. Oh, all the stuff is taken.
Yeah.
Oh, right. We're literally back at the start. We gotta go down to the ground, I think, now.
Here. Go down to the ground, and I'm gonna brown.
I'm gonna brown! I ain't getting nothing out of that shit. I'm going down, because I need treasure. Fuck the Shrine of Chance. Also, honestly, you know what one thought that does slay me though, Zig?
Or
thinking about JT like sadly listening to Tears of a Clown. Well, in his room or something like that.
Uh-huh.
Ooh, I got an old guillotine.
Nice.
Ooh. Medpack. He's probably not doing that. Knowing him is with his his boss.
Yeah.
you think you know what I mean, Zig?
Yeah, his gaslighting girl boss.
The one who wears the pants in the relationship.
Exactly.
She doesn't! He watches the stream. Shiny, happy people holding hands.
Shiny, happy people holding hands.
Shiny, happy people holding. Oh my fucking god. Poor Jane. Oh god. He's like Zig, he's like Johnny Zez.
Oh my. But he hasn't broken yet or anything like that.
He's stronger. The thing is he's trying to be a clown. The thing is he's the punchline.
I know. But he hasn't gone down like the Dark Zest route just yet, you know what I'm saying?
He hasn't shot a burglar while someone's getting married at his house.
Yeah. But that'll be next RPG Tuesday.
Next RPG Tuesday. Watch as every dog gets his day. Next time, it's like a fucking TV show. Next time.
Next time on the Marek1shtar, on the Marek1shtar stream. And it's just like it's like a fucking like very bad like soap opera and shit. And you just see a close up of like you know JT with the Glock.
It starts playing the song. Take it from me. It's a jungle out there. Started when my neighbors moved to town. Take it from me. You gotta smile just to survive. They monkey around. Make a fool of me so. Strangers getting married in my home. Well, I got my steel-toed shoes on my feet. I'ma mash up their mangas tonight. Actually, no. Well, technically, he did... Remember, he did technically go to a wedding. Remember that one part of Dragon Quest?
Oh, yeah.
It just... Except... Technically, he wasn't invited. Quote-unquote. Technicality.
Mm. All he's missing now is the burglar.
You just see me go to his house. I dress up in a balaclava and everything. Oh god. What if you woke up and your life was just like the meme housing? How would you feel?
I'd be like, where's the CBT wizard? Who are you people?
Who are you people? Where's the
CBT? I'm just cooking and I'm flossing at the same time.
Once again, the worst part about the mods in that is that sometimes, like, certain mods just take over.
Yeah.
It's like when they're not programmed right, then everybody's just fucking flossing. Non-stop. Oh god. Whoa! Hey, big boy! Ooh, we got a healing drone now. Should we do the coffee corn without him just to really, like, you know?
I got
you covered. Tell me when it's all ready and I'll say the line.
All right.
Yo, Odie's gonna report this to him next week! Welcome everybody to JT's Coffee Corner.
So, Marek, watch any good movies? Did you watch anything, any good movies, seen any good shows as of lately?
No. Oh, well, I've been playing Smash Brothers a lot more. Actually, I did play a little bit of, whatchamacallit, Jedi Outcast. I'm trying to get past a certain level, and I actually made some decent progress, unexpectedly. But
oh, cool.
I keep running into various snags.
Hmm.
Though I don't know. I guess it's because my ever increasing personal poverty.
Yeah.
I am feeling a slight itch to play Fallout 4 again.
Huh.
I know, shocker, right?
Yeah.
But I don't know. I feel like shooting the riot shotgun that I got from the mod, so I don't know.
That sounds pretty cool.
Yeah, I got like a bunch of characters. But yeah, most of my time has really been spent working on this comic strip I'm writing with Mutter, one of the co-hosts. Well, you know Mutter. For the sake of everybody else in chat and everything like that.
Mutter is a really cool artist and everything like that.
Yeah, check him out, he's on Twitter. At Warm Chills.
Yeah, Warm Chills and shit.
He's always changing his style.
Yeah, so it's like, you know, it's really cool, like, that's just the, like, that's the reason why I like his art, though, is like, you know, where he's always, like, experimenting with his style and everything like that, you know what I mean?
He's one of those artists who does, like, a certain style for everything.
Mm-hmm.
So, it's like, oh, this is a specific style, that isn't... But it's all his own as a thing. But yeah, so I've mainly been spending some of my free time writing for that. And honestly, I can't believe it's not. I'm not written a lot, but I honestly can't believe the amount of them I've written.
Mhm.
Cause I just kind of take it like panel by panel. Then I work. I just kind of work in like the comedy and everything like that from there. Resonance disc. Charger killing enemies fires automatic. Oh, I got a soul cube. Cool. But yeah, so You do anything fun, Zig, this week so far?
Well, let's see. Well, since I really don't have cable TV anymore, I've just been using what streaming services I have and whatnot just to watch, like, you know, my shows and shit.
Yeah.
So I've been watching a lot of Space Ghost as of late and whatnot. You know what I mean?
Found the teleporter.
Yeah. Want to activate it or not yet?
Tell me when you're ready.
I'm ready whenever you are.
Alright. Head by it and I'll pull the switch. So you've been
I'm already there.
Oh, you've been watching Space Ghost Coast to Coast?
Yeah.
And how's that going for you?
Going pretty well. And what else? What else have I been? Well, I've been, well, since, you know, I've moved, well, since I moved to, like, you know, PA and shit, you know, Pennsylvania and whatnot.
Mm-hmm.
I've actually just been going around just to see, like, what's, you know, there for, like, entertainment and shit, or just, like, any cool, like, places and whatnot, you know what I'm saying? So.
Fuck yeah.
It really has been just, like, you know, like, I went to a mall the other day, you know what I'm saying?
I've grown to like malls better than fucking Walmart and Target.
Yeah, but it's just like, this mall was a bit sweet dead and shit, you know what I'm talking about.
Ooh, how many stores were closed in it?
I would say a good chunk, but at least it had like an arcade. But the only like game of like interest for me was the Aliens arcade game that they had and whatnot.
Is it?
And it was like one of the older like Aliens shooter games and shit, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, the one. Alright. The. I love Aliens Armageddon, but I even get tired of that shit. Is that a chest all the way out there?
I forget if it was like Alien Resurrection or some shit like that, or like Aliens Resurrection, whatever.
The frickin'. It's not. Like.
Uh-huh.
Oh, yeah, a bunch of chests over here. I think.
Oh, cool. Let me.
Let's see.
So you were saying?
Cause like the one that I really enjoy, the one with the guns that are mounted on the cabinet.
Yeah. Oh that... yeah, that's the same one that I've actually. That's the same one that I played in shit.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah. No, like that. Like that one. That one used to be everywhere, but now it's not. Like the cause. Once again, old arcade cabinets and shit, right?
Right.
Then Aliens Armageddon is everywhere, though.
Mm-hmm.
But, like, that one gets tiresome because it doesn't really have, like, a story and it's just very linear, you know what I mean?
Yeah, I know what you mean.
It's, like, it's one of the very minor issues I have with a lot of rail shooters nowadays in the arcade.
Yeah, like... The only ones that seem to have, like, some sort of, like, semblance of a story and shit seems to be, like, you know, House of the Dead and whatnot, you know what I'm saying? When it comes to rail shooters, at least.
And even then, like, Scarlet Dawn, while it's still, you know, there and, like, you know, loud and proud and everything about it, it's still kind of, like, being campy. Once again, this is, like, House of the Dead is silly. It's not, you know...
The House of the Dead.
Yeah, like, it's not meant to have, like, super anguish and shit. But,
mm-hmm.
But yeah, like, the worst... But yeah, like, that's pretty cool that they had, like, the one with the cabinet-mounted guns.
Yeah. And then, what else did I watch there also?
Though, you can actually...
I actually watched that fucking Self, video... The Night Self video and whatnot, the search for self.
Oh yeah, the one that inspired by Creepypasta that I haven't published anywhere yet.
Yeah. I thought, you know, I actually did think that was actually pretty interesting and whatnot.
It, like, the reason why I got my idea for the Creepypasta is because I just find it interesting that, you know what I mean, that this search for this boss has been around for like 20 fucking years almost, right? It's like, do you at least, do you understand the story a little bit better? After, like, watching something like that?
A little bit. I'm not gonna lie, I actually do. I do get it now and shit like that. You know what I'm saying?
Like,
it's just like,
oh, fucking these guys.
Yeah.
You understand it a little bit more now that, you know, you got a bit more context of what the hell self is. It's one of those creepy pastas for the fiends, you know what I mean?
Yeah. So, you know, at least it's cool, you know, it's pretty interesting how, like, you know, 20 years of just, like, you know, all this data mining and everything like that, slowly but surely they're, you know, picking up the pieces of what, like, you know, what the hell self is.
It wants to be found, Zig. He wants to be found, Zig.
Yeah, yeah.
We don't know what's gonna happen if he is. Reduces cooldown. Oh, I got another alien head. Cool.
Nice.
But yeah, like that, like that's the, I like, cause I want to see what he designed too, cause I even, like, that was like the best part of like writing that story was, what is my hypothetical design for self that I'm not going to have a visual of because, you know.
Yeah.
I kind of have a thought of what he looked like, at least in the context of, like, the story that I wrote in my head.
Mm-hmm.
Because, like, the way I described it. But it's probably, more often than not, like, not something that was designed around the,
Yeah.
Like, that's the whole sort of, like, case in point thing with that. So, I highly doubt that it's a fucking night. I highly doubt that it's like some sort of like weird otherworldly entity and shit, but
yeah.
It, like I said, it, with stuff like that, you just have to have fun with it, you know?
Yeah, no. At least, you know, at least it's like your like interpretation of like what you think it's going to, of what it would look like and shit. So it's like, I can't really, you know.
It's better than this one. It's kind of like a response to this one creepypasta I, like, read years ago about it, where all that happens in it is, like, oh, yeah, let's go, like, I data mined an old copy of the game, and I managed to get into, like, I found out that the boss was, like, a, whatchamacallit, a cut. I found out the boss was, like, a cut carrot, was, like, in the cut Clarice level or whatever. And
yeah.
It's like, then for like 5 minutes, they described this like a deep voice was saying like all sorts of like slurs, and I'm like, is this meant to be scary?
I don't know. Like if your creepypasta has to like, you know, resort to like using like slurs and shit like that, to be like, you know, scary or like, you know. That's not how the game is supposed to be, then, I don't know, that's not scary to me, that's just more so, like, funny in, like, a very, like, you know, in a very, like, like, are you really fucking trying, are you really going down this route sort of way, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, in a very try-hardy way and everything like that.
It's...
So I'm just like, you know.
The worst part is that, like, it's like, It's kind of like the whole Toby Fox dilemma, like, remember with the Halloween hack and how...
Yeah.
Despite him really trying... Really hoping! No one talks about it again, right?
People still talk about it to this day.
They bring it up because... Because it's not even really relevant. But, like, he even tries... He even, like, dismisses it because he was a different person back then.
Yeah.
So it's like... It's like, have you... Like, once again, when you play the Halloween hack, it's fucking...
It's like what?
The Dr. and Donuts fight at the end when he just all he does is say like he calls like the main character a you know.
Yeah, I know.
An F slur, a Q slur, and it's just like once again, like how I said yesterday, that's not Mr. Bean, or like that's not whatever. It's like that's not
Mr. Bean. That's not Dr. Andonuts.
That's not Dr. Andonuts. Oh. It's true though.
Yeah.
Oh! Are you guys talking about the Earthbound Halloween hack? But yes, yes I am. The thing that nobody ever... I only bring it up because it has to do... It, I only bring it up, like, I want to leave it dead and buried too, to, like, you know. But almost every freaking video I see, half the time where they talk about Toby Fox, and if they always talk about, like, how he was making Earthbound hacks, and he doesn't want to think about that time.
Mm-hmm.
It's like... Oh my god.
Yeah.
The frickin' music was electric. I got one of the items that let you just attack without doing anything. But yeah, it's very... It's just really awkward when you see that. It's just like... Wow, and I'm like, this is supposed to be good. Like even when I first heard about like the Halloween hack, and I looked it up and I saw that, I'm like, this isn't scary. This is just kind of stupid.
Yeah.
Like, oh, Doctor, and the, you know the first person who ever brought it up though in a video was right.
Math Pat.
Matthew Pathew. Hello, everybody. Welcome to Game Theory, the smartest show in gaming.
Hello, Internet. Welcome to Game Theory, the only show that'll take a cactus and shove it right up your fucking keyhole. That's what he says, right?
Cause I am the LA Beast.
Have a good day.
Fucking, like, we need more LA Beasts, we need less, we need more LA Beasts, we need less frickin' Mad Pat in our lives.
Yeah. You know, at least fucking, LA Beast was trying to do something pretty cool about, like, his, fucking, you know, interests and everything like that. Trying to bring back Crystal Pepsi after all these years and shit.
It's
and
a
being like a spokesperson to Pepsi and shit.
It's back, but it's a down. It's a downtrend item.
Yeah.
I think I gotta go to the. No. It's a. I gotta go. That was stupid. I gotta go to the hospital.
Or the fact that you ate like a whole bag of like fucking. Sugar-free gummy bears and shit.
I had, by the way, with the LA Beast, I had my he looked at me moment. This is back when I was still in college. I was watching one of his live streams before class, and I said like, "Hey Beast, how's it going?" And he's like, "Hey Marek1shtar." He's like, "Marek,"
oh, that's nice.
And I'd be like, "Marek1shtar," and I'm like. In my head, I'm like, he looked at me! I had, like, my freaking Fury Road, he looked at me. What the fuck was the guy that Kilbane's from, Saints Row?
Immortan Joe. And then, there's, fucking, what can you call it? By the way, the guy who played the fucking main villain in Fury Road was the same guy who played like the main villain in like the first Mad Max.
Really?
Yeah, I think. Again, I like to bring that. Little fun fact up.
The only character I can think of when I think of Fury Road is Furiosa for some reason. Oh shit, I got more sniper shots actually.
Oh, nice.
Also, good luck when we gotta try to find the fucking, like, teleporter here.
Oh, yeah.
This fucking map is a pain in the ass. Because remember, we could also accidentally activate, like, a teleport that takes us. The one that takes us back to, like, the beginning.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, shit, I'm dead.
What killed you?
I don't know. Well, Merrick, you're on your own.
Wait, did you go into the void zone?
Yeah, I think I did by accident.
Oh, yeah, they constantly just drain your health in there.
Yeah.
By the way, I was playing this with Rubescent like a while back,
mm-hmm.
and I got fucking stuck game theory. Now we're in space with Markiplier.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, I forgot about that.
Yeah, Markiplier just made that in space with Markiplier.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. 4, 3, 2, 1. Rangers in space. it's literally just Power Rangers in space, but with Markiplier is like one of the Rangers.
Yeah.
Set controls to outer space now, flying higher than ever before. Rangers in space, go Power Rangers, go! Rangers, go Power Rangers, go, 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 fly, go Power Ranger! Rangers, go Power Rangers, go in space! Fuck yeah. Flip on thrusters, fire the rockets, save the future, long live the Power Rangers in space. I'm such a I feel so old. I wasn't even alive at the time of In Space's airing, is the funny part.
Yeah, I know. For me, it was like fucking Time Force that was like really, what really like, you know, introduced me to like Power Rangers and shit, and I'm just like, I like cool robot owl, Vinny the Bobber.
Fucking. For me, it was, there's a light in the distance. You see them coming closer with the force of ages. Centuries gone by, protectors of the right, defenders sworn to fight.
That's Donald Thunder, right?
Yeah. Power Rangers roar! Power Rangers score! Save us from these evil forces! Power Rangers Dino Thunder! Victory is ours forevermore.
Mm-hmm.
Protectors of the light. Defenders sworn to fight. That one, and then the one that really got me into Power Rangers was SPD Emergency. Fucking SPD. It's got all this stuff I like. Giant robots. This sounds familiar. Giant robots. Fucking aliens. Dude. It's like the show is made for me. I love the dinosaur one. I haven't seen that many episodes of it. It's really, really good. Yeah, Mezagog. The villain Mezagog was a good villain. He had like the freaking Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde thing going on.
Yeah.
With the White Ranger's dad.
Mm-hmm.
Then he turns into a, then he turns into like a fucking dragon and they have to kill him.
Yeah.
Go Power Rangers, go in space. Oh yeah, here's the teleporter.
Alright.
Alright, let's go. It's time to turn it on. Change. Fight evil, though, set the city day. They're the ones gonna save the day. Make a better change. Let's go. Here come the Power Rangers. Here come the Power Rangers. Boy! Fucking hell! I'm just dominating! You know what the thing is, Zig?
What's up?
You know that one problem that I have with a lot of, like, roguelikes where you just unlock the one character that just fucking dominates?
Yeah.
You know what's something? This character, the Railgunner here, should be that character for me, but oddly enough, there's enough of a difference in all of the items and how you can fucking, like, play around with, like, the builds that it doesn't get tiresome to play as this guy. Or just to play this game in general.
Yeah.
Like, I played this in some of my free time when I could. And it's just like, holy shit. So Hoodie, if you've ever heard me before, I actually have a roguelike that I genuinely enjoy. Oh boy, Zig, we're on the moon.
We're gonna be whalers on the moon?
We're whalers on the moon. We carry a harpoon. But there ain't no whale, so we told tales and sang a whaling tune. I got a whole deck filled with equipment, man!
I know.
What do you have? Wait, how much stuff do you have, Zig?
I have, like, one row filled with, like, shit, and then I just have, like, two things on my other, like, you know, little, whatchamacallit here.
I somehow have two rows of fucking stuff. Okay, do you see the energy towers in the distance?
Yeah, I believe so.
Yeah, though, we gotta go to those and we gotta activate them.
Alright.
I didn't get tired of a freaking roguelike, holy shit. I guess it's because it feels good, like, it feels good to just generally play this game, so.
Yeah.
Hey, blam! Oh, shit. With all these drones that we have, everything is dying. Hello. The only thing I gotta worry about actually is to have like one of those things that breaks.
Yeah.
Fire!
If you survive, guess what you get as a reward.
Oh boy. What is it?
You get you get about like 10 of those lunar coins.
Oh nice.
Do you get them if you die though, as long as somebody beats the campaign?
I'm not really sure. But I'm not intending to die, like, you know, this time around.
Never get overconfident in your skills.
Yeah.
I learned that the hard way once. I almost died during the final boss, but I made it. Two one shot! Yay! Two one shot! I kinda do have like a Ghostbuster style backpack.
It's the ectoplasm. There is too much ectoplasm in the toilet.
I call the cops. But they bring a shotgun! Oh no, it's murder! Well, I'm certified for both ghosts and not ghosts, so. My gun is good for both, because I have that, and I have the big energy beam, and I have like these regular bullets. Also, you know what else I think, Zig? There's something about like getting like a little drone and like all this other stuff that like attacks for you in like 3D rather than like 2D or something like that, like most roguelikes. That just hits it right for me. Whoa! The orbs of light! I think I almost died there. These guys are worse than the final boss, actually. At least in my opinion. Oh, you know what? I've actually been thinking of picking up Stalker.
Oh, cool. Yeah, I saw it's on sale and whatnot.
Yeah, it's like $3, but I don't know if I, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. Alright. I'm gonna charge this pillar over here.
Speaking of roguelikes, I got a new one. Skull the Hero Killer. I have not heard of it. I am playing a game that I was afraid was a roguelike, but it turned out to not be. There was a very similar game called Have a Nice Death. That is about like the same type of thing and is a roguelike. Health is at 1,000. Oh yeah, actually we can still get items and stuff.
Oh, nice.
Because we have the we have like those clipboards that let us get like airdrops or whatever.
Yeah.
I think they only spawn on like a certain location, but I'm not sure. I think we can get up to the boss now. Do we have to find any more of those towers?
Nah, I just said like four of those pillars and shit, so I think we're good.
Alright, we're gravy then. I found one of the things though. Wanna grab what's in it? There's a shield.
Sure, I'll take the shield.
Bye-bye. There's usually another one of those things over here, but I don't see one, so... Now, there's gotta be a... You see the thing at the top? We gotta... There's gotta be, like, a big... Wait a minute, I see it over there.
Oh, okay.
There's the charger... There's the charger thing.
Oh, there's more? Alright.
Nah, it's the pillar that's gonna take us up to the top.
Oh, okay. Just wait up for me, alright?
Gotcha. Another settlement needs your help. I'll mark it on your map. Alright, I'm holding out for you.
Alright, fuck!
As I just rapidly heal. It'd be kind of funny if the freaking healing drones would heal you without the need for- without, like... when you're not injured.
Yeah.
That way it just increases your armor. Hey, no! Back off, you big spider walker!
Alright, I'm here.
Alright, cool. All right, Zig.
All right, Merrick.
He's in there. Let's do it. Got like four phases. He also likes to dodge like slow charging attacks. So hitting him with the big laser is kind of hard, but it does good damage.
Oh, I think he likes me.
Yep. Kind of wish it was a melee. I kind of wish I had like a melee attack or something. Well, good thing we got all these drones on our side. The only thing that doesn't come up here are the turrets. Now that I think about that, that actually would be kind of sick to have all of them up here, like, helping us shoot them or something.
Yeah.
Like, they all just instantly teleport up here or whatever. Hey, dodged. All right, phase two. You know all those enemies?
Yeah.
Yep, we just gotta fight them. I don't even think this is like the easiest of the phases. I still think the last phase is like the easiest.
Oh, okay.
This is only easy because I think there's... Once again, you mainly only have to kill the enemies and that's kind of it. Mm-hmm. Alright, here he comes again. He's ready for round two! Right, yeah, he summons like a bunch of enemies now.
Yeah.
And he steals an attack from the Snatcher, so... All of our drones are dead. Okay. Final phase. You know all that gear we have?
He takes it all.
Mm-hmm. But thankfully this is more of a gimmick fight, so... If you just fucking, you know... Unload, he's good. See? Easy as pie. And the fire. Alright, we gotta get to the portal. Now. Zig, do you remember where that ship was? Just run. Run.
I'm running as fast as I can.
Just go as fast as humanly possible.
Oh shit, I just fell down. But I'm almost there. Hi, Merrick.
Hello. Alright, so you wanna know what we just gotta do? We just run right into the frickin' port there. Just stay in here. Do not leave.
Alright.
We just gotta wait this out. We just gotta fucking wait this out. We're safe as long as we hunker down inside. Yep. I think we're actually in a good spot right now because nothing really made it too close. Mm-hmm. We're surrounded by four walls. Imagine they updated that everything fucking just, everything just able to shoot. What happened?
I went out by accident. Alright, I'm
Victory screech! Woo! I did it. We did it on stream.
And without JT.
You know what's the funny part, Zig?
Yeah.
Of the few times I played this with JT on stream, and we made it to the Mithrix, he always died.
Oh.
So that's even a bigger dunk on. Oh, wait, Zig, you unlock the captain now, actually, then.
Yay!
So you have another character!
And so it left, ready to recharge.
So now you have the captain, and guess what his weapons are?
Oh, cool, what is it?
He gets a cool shotgun, and he gets cooldown airstrikes.
Hmm.
You wanna go for a test run?
I'd love to, but, you know, I have work in the morning and shit.
Yeah, plus true.
Plus, it's also the first day I go into the office and whatnot, so, you know. You
gotta be ready.
Yeah.
You gotta get that suit on.
It's mostly business casual, but you get the point.
Suit and tie, your coffee mug, you're all ready to go.
Yeah.
And you're all set to kick some fucking ass in the office.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, we beat it without JT. Also, by the way, you can skip the credits.
Oh, okay.
But yeah, like, we beat Risk of Rain without JT.
Mm-hmm.
And that means I got another 10, whatchamacallit, and you got a 10, whatchamacallit. Lunar coins. Honestly, if you head off, I maybe want to go through it one more time with the commando to see how far I get. I'm probably not gonna last.
All right.
But yeah, like, nah. I still find it hard to believe I really enjoy this freaking thing I really enjoy this roguelike. Of all of the ones that I have, or mm-hmm. I've ever played, it's just this very random one that even I'm like, bruh, like, really? What? Yeah. Like, why is this game so addicting? I don't even freaking know. Like, other than it being like 3D, I think like that's basically it. Like some of the effects are really cool in like 3D. Yeah. Oh god, I'm so used to the frickin' I'm so used to the fucking the Railgunner.
Yeah.
But I actually legitimately enjoy the commando too.
That's nice.
He runs around like, look, any character that runs around with dueling pistols or machine pistols or something like that, I'm bound to love it. I don't know why. Let's see, where is? It's even like in Ratchet Deadlocked.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, like, that game, Ratchet gets, like, two fucking machine pistols, and I'm like, it's infinitely better. And there hasn't been a game since where they... kind of copied that sort of deal. Because, like, let's be real here. In most cases, dual-wielding is inherently better. What are you talking about? There's no practical application for it. It's still fucking cool.
Yeah.
You can do stuff like gun fu, kick fucking ass, you know what I mean?
I know gun fu.
I know frog fu! chance to collapse enemies.
Oh. Alright. I think we're gonna hop off for now, Merrick.
Alright, man.
Thanks for having me on.
Have a good one, buddy.
Thank you, too. Have a good night.
Have a good one.
Again, have a good night, everyone.
Have a good one, dude. And then there was one. If I could already beat the game with the frickin' Railgunner on my own, I wonder if I could do something. I wonder if I can do the same with whatchamacallit, the commando. The other character I'm really good at solo. I tried playing the whatchamacallit solo, the engineer, but didn't work out too well. Though I do like going around as the engineer with like a bunch of shit, though. It's kind of fun. Maybe I'll give that a second chance. Maybe I'll give that a chance off stream, then I'll try to do it live one day. Maybe for a not RPG Tuesday, or maybe an RPG Tuesday where JT wants to play the game live or something. Oh, we get the void effect now. So I did, basically, all the bullshit. Engineer's a cool character, very supportive role. Yeah. Like I like the turrets that, and how they kind of like gain all of your upgrades and shit too. In favor of just having like an automatic gun. Like, that type of shit is fucking awesome. Is that why you're also throwing more bombs? It's just that it's easy to damage enemies and, like, sort of critical chance them as, like, something like the fucking, what's the name of that? The Railgunner. And, like, characters, like... Like, there's characters that I would totally play as for multiplayer, and there's characters that I would definitely play as, like, single player, like this guy. Like single targets, boom, 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 boom. Pop, 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 that's me. The fuck is that over there? The real question, though, is do I try to get the better? I don't want to do that unless I have, like, a multiplayer partner, actually. If you actually get down to half health, then you're fucked. You cannot kill the battery. I think about it. Maybe I could pull it off as like the Railgunner or something. You cannot kill the battery. Oh, it took my soda. Boo. I feel like I've been in the void portal. My health is almost drained and I'm gonna die immediately. Is this how much I've lost the ability to play as the frickin' commando here? It's either that or these guys. Oh, medic. Perma significantly reduces armor on... Really? Now I'm getting some... Oh, no. No, you don't. Now I'm getting some firepower. So what do we got over here? What is this? Oh. You cannot kill the battery. Oh, I got a little scorpion tail. Cool. Wait a minute. Does getting void items spawn more void type enemies? I might be a little afraid now. I don't know. Okay. Cause I saw a couple enemies turn purple and I was thinking like, oh geez, wait. I'm like, oh boy, here we go. Here comes the part where now everything's gonna get extremely difficult. No more chests. Oh no! That's a bad sign! I got the jellyfish. That actually wasn't so bad. Fire an electric nova at low health. Oh god, and wait, that would probably spread the... That's evil! That's actually only on the pretense of if I get to low health anyway. But what are the chances now I can shoot an enemy? Oh god. I can shoot an enemy now, right? If it explodes and hits another enemy, does that also spread the gas, like the gas effect with like the enemies will collapse it on themselves. All right, cool. I'm free to pick up all this other stuff I missed. Oh boy, what I get? What I get? Real, it was a healing nova. You know what? I'll take it. I need all the help I can get now. Oh! Okay. Guillotine. Nice. And I got the slug for free. Well, not free necessarily, but I got the slug for money. Rather than having to trade an item for it. Yeah, I think we're all set to go. Man, I don't know where I was coming off thinking this was going to be all, but... Oh, hey, a drone. Ooh, a gunner drone. My worry slowly went away, though. I did get lowered down to fucking normal, so it's going to be a battle. It's gonna be a big battle! You got your first death in Hero Killer. Oh god. Well then, perfect amount of gold for that scenario. I'm just glad I don't gotta deal with those fucking rats. I just had to say rats. Yep, bad news is, I actually figured out the boss on my first, just made a dumb mistake. No, that's fair, that happens to the best of us. At least it's not like, could be like, at least the boss is not badly designed. I hope anyways. Oh god though, if all those rats were void rats, I'd be fucking dead. What's that? You like decompressing on yourself? I kind of wish I got a clipboard. I need a manifest. It's nicely designed as a first boss. I even had a vintage over, advantage over it because I had a ranged skull, but I just didn't quite figure out the dodge rolling and did not see the attack. I'm like, ah. Fair. It is what it is, and it happens to, like I said, it happens to the best of us, so don't feel discouraged. Bro, I'm not this good. I'm going to kick this rookie's ass. Discourages. I don't want to risk it. You take the void tunnel thing, you drone. God, these flying manta rays are what's killing me for the most part, but at least I got that freaking damage nova thing. Another lens crafter's cool. That is a void enemy, I think. Yep, that is a void enemy. But I got him before he got me, so that's all that counts. Oh god, oh god. I almost died there. That would have been bad. I'm about to end this man's whole career. So far, so good, though, like... You have been getting low on health, but the drones have kind of been covering for that. And I have that damage, Nova. Gladly take that. And dead. Nothing up here, okay. A little worried because I haven't seen the teleporter yet. Because it might be beyond that. Second death was just as bad. I don't think it's as bad as this situation right over here. Oh, the teleporter is right inside too. Also, there was any particular void that you would like. Honestly, the ukulele is awesome. This one that I have right now, I'm liking. There's actually quite a few, I just don't know the names of them. So... That's the challenge. I know JT calls them like side grades or whatever, but I'm like, nah, these feel like straight upgrades as opposed to side grades. A side grade is like, I don't know where he's coming from with that. But yeah, the void ukulele is like killer. So I'd go. So if I had to, pick only one, I'd say the ukulele. Or no. Actually, no. The one that just attacks for me. I don't need to press a single button. It just launches out those little pellets and just fucking slam into everything and hurt them. That one I like a lot. Some of them can be side grades with some characters, like Void Fungus with Engineer. That's not good. But something like Void Credit classes it. It makes it even has a lower chance of proc. The worst one that I've encountered so far is like the Void Teddy Bear. It gives you like a shield, but I don't know if it like. It gives you like a shield and it corrupts, but like. But it doesn't stack. It's weird. Teddy bear that revives you, and the teddy bear that gives you a slight chance of not being hit. I didn't even know that there was one that could revive you if you get hurt. If you get severely injured. Is that one? I'd probably like that one a lot. The fruit of my worth. What is that down there? Nothing. That one's what you get slightly does attack and makes it really good. Ah. But yeah, like the avoid all damage one for like one hit. That's kind of cool. But you can kind of get the same effect with like a weird combo of items, so. It's not that, like, super effective, so to speak. And I'm dead. Before I can even use my fancy fruit. Oh, that was pretty good. The one that's what you get slightly does attack. See who else do I have here? The Huntress. I did not mean to do that, but okay. I like this game, but the menus work weird with a controller. Who's this? The Bandit. Serrated dagger. Actually, you know what? I want to give the bandit a try. He seems pretty cool. Before we head out, I think I'll go one more round. But yeah, no, like, I actually legitimately enjoy a lot of this game, so wait, where's the... Ah, so it's not a full auto character. Gotcha. That's fair. But yeah, so far my survivability in single player placates on that I'm able to play through as the whatchamacallit. What's the name of that character? The Railgunner. Got a mommy with a gun. I'm going to assume you mean mummy. Okay, cool. I got a healing drone. Oh, I can turn invisible. Cool. The one that's dead. The mummy. Okay. Light Sight Attack. Extra treachery special skill. Ooh. Means I can go invisible for twice. Neat. Start a mutiny. Pop this. Bop, 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 bop. Danger, danger, close, danger, close. Get away. I don't need weirdos getting too close to me. Pop, 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 pop. Come on. Bastard! These things are... The one thing I could definitely say that I don't like about this... Not the reloading. Three deaths and they have different bosses and I got none from the rookie. Huh. Gubo Jr. Oh. What do we get? Oh, we're good. I got a stim. Alright. Yeah, this is definitely gonna be my last round. So when I die, I die. You got this. Just think like a bandit. I'm not too worried. Like, I'm not too worried about dying, Hoodie. It's just that I'm like, whatchamacallit. I'm a tire. And I don't know why. But no, like, I'm not afraid of death in this, really. Like, I'm liking this character too a little bit. I just gotta try to get used to his moves, and I gotta find the right equipment for him and shit. We got this. Whoa, we got this. So easy. Cherry soda, cherry soda, cherry soda. Cloak when I jump. This ain't like DF2 at all. You know what? Maybe Bandit would be good for us. Maybe Bandit would be another character that's good for multiplayer. Like, I'll try out the captain again when I'm, like, not playing solo. I wonder who... I think I'm gonna raid somebody. I don't even know how many people we got here. Two people? Some raid, huh? Alright. I think I'm gonna hit the sack, too. You got somebody? Alright, cool. Share them in the chat and I'll hand it off. But yeah, I finally beat Risk of Rain 2 live. And I didn't do it with JT. the 2-0 duo actually did it. I can't believe that shit. We don't suck at video games. Or I just use like a... Or use like a well-balanced... Totally not broken fun to play character in a roguelike. Piggy's still alive? Let me see. Oh yeah, he is. Making my dad proud. Oh, he's playing Lego Star Wars. Cool. Oh, Aegon just went offline too. Oh man. Alright, cool. We'll raid Piggy. So, I learned that anything is possible when your friend who's a clown isn't around. To me, anything is possible when your friend who's a clown ain't around. To do all sorts of thingamabobs. And you can actually beat a game while live with a good friend of yours. And everything. I don't know. Also, void items are inherently upgrades in comparison to everything else. So, anyway, guys, thank you guys for joining us tonight. I hope you guys enjoyed. And remember, as always, be yourselves and remember, Makalekaha, Makahani Ho, Mo, Makacha, Makamo, Makahay, Pickle Barrel, Kumquat, Jimmy Cherry Chonga. And that's the secret word of the day. Alright, guys, catch you all later. Merrick out. See you guys.